Look at that. Local town in the bullseye of the next big wildfire, looking to make waves, as in sound waves, to douse the flames.
This town's very much a town of activists, and we really galvanize after Paradise.
What started as a class project by college students now has the Nevada City mayor wondering if it'll make the grade when it comes to putting out the flames.
Certainly looks pretty cool, right? CBS 13's Rick Boone is live near the foothills on how this thing works. Rick?
Yeah, Adrian and Tony, listen up. This could be a proactive device instead of a fire truck going out to the next wildfires. Another town is getting really desperate out there trying to figure out a way to stop those fires before they even start. It's a sound that's similar to a guitar bass. The effect is meant to save lives and property.
We're really here to help people, and we're really here to prevent the catastrophes that come from fires.
These guys created the Soundwave fire extinguisher as a class project at George Mason University.
We did like an illegal fire in a lab, and like we were so surprised that we miniaturized it and then we just put it out.
They stumbled across the idea after reading a theory to put out fires, even wildfires, with sound. The setup is quite easy. Basically a speaker, a funnel for the sound to come out, so the secret ingredient to put out the fire is all about that bass. In fact, for it to work, the bass must be between 30 to 60 hertz. The goal, they want to place these speakers in wooded areas or connect to drones.
This town's very much a town of activists, and we really galvanize after Paradise.
The Soundwave Firebuster still needs more research and development, and the mayor of Nevada City wants to sign her town up for it.
And having possibly land available for when they're doing prescription burns, so they can actually do some trials on the devices. Also perhaps some vehicles or some input as far as their own skills or expertise.
Enthusiasm, some residents are sounding off with approval.
I always wondered about sound being able to do disruption, so we'll see how this develops.
There is one issue to solve. Since there's no liquid or foam involved, the sound waves can't cool down something after it's been on fire, but the creators say they're working on it.
If the technology is going to exist, we might as well be the ones to make it happen.
And Sharon and Tony, there is more to hear about this story. I did reach out to some fire departments about whether or not they believe this technology could actually work. They all gave me pretty much the same answer. Let's see more research and development.